Welcome back, everybody, into the game, which we have now re-hosted back up again with a lovely safe thing, just in time to watch BZZ die here on the...
No, nope, he doesn't! Nope. Rage teleport. Rage teleport. They have nothing to be able to stop that. Oh, my goodness. That is why...
Scythe device?
Yeah, you would love to see that, but again, just like the Venomancer Enchantress... You have no disables, let alone disables that can actually get through that rage. So not only do you have a chance at being able to like catch him out without his rage, like you don't actually have a disable. Like that smoke surprise gank, they couldn't even like actually be able to throw down a disable in time. Mm-hmm. So that the gank was never going to work as long as he was actually paying attention. Just instant rage teleport. He has enough health. It's not like they do massive physical damage that quickly, so...
Movement. Oh, Seed Door, he found one. He found Illidan. He needs the Bane to come around the corner, though, and Goldblack, he Nightmares up one, and Fiends grips up the other. So they can kill off Judgment quickly, then the arrow to make sure that NSA is exactly where he is, and they go through one and then two of the supports, maybe even able to catch out Illidan himself, which is where they all start this one up. A four-star on cooldown for now, but the run... Damn, that range of open wounds. In comes Sergei, though. He pops off both ulti as well as BKB. Illidan will survive. Sergei stealing off the damage. 140. BZZ staying with him. 168 points of damage with the Soul Assumption. He's like, how much damage he's got? He's got to keep the life points with it to stay alive. And Bounty Hunter for some reason died behind the line. So four players dead for VP on this top lane as we resume what is now part two of what will be for people who will watch the VODs later, your VOD. And for people who are watching live, it is the conclusion of RoXKIS versus VP for the MLG TKO tournament. I am TobiWan and I'm joined by Dota Capitalist here in the broadcast. And coming up next is Cloud9 versus Liquid. We actually saw them. They're all inside the lobby ready to start. So we lived no delay coming up into the next game. Great Dota, and RoXKIS is going to try and go high ground here.
Wait. So this is the second game of the series?
I'm sorry. Whoa!
I'm thinking JDL all of a sudden. I'm thinking two game series here.
No, whoa. That's a one game series, dude. This is part two of the saga.
That's right.
Only because we had to split it in halves, like a Lord of the Rings trilogy. It didn't end properly. Now, RoXKIS, Lifestealer, destroys the Enchantress, and they're going in deep, and the Familiars are zoning out NS with the Soul Assumption damage coming out from Yol. They've managed to bring down the Tier 3 tower, but we've got the Razor back on the front lines. He's still got ultimate available, and they're wanting to back up right there, and we'll kick the Vietnamese cast next game. Goldblack, nice Fiend script, right over on top of the Bounty Hunter right now. They hold him in position. Those Quills are not making it easy for RoXKIS, though. They find themselves very low on life, and Illidan just keeps beating in. He's dishing out 250 damage per hit, but he's got to keep his back to him right now, but it looks like that doesn't matter. But the damage, even from Sergei in Nightmare, he can trigger out the Aegis, the Immortal of the Lifestealer. He's looking to get rid of Yol as well. Static Link is available. He's going to pick off the first one. Now the Static Link to Lifestealer. He's going to man mode this and stay with BZZ. It's his only option. TP out. How much DPS can you dish out? The answer is not enough. The Rax in the middle lane will remain alive for now. And VP, they push RoXKIS back.
They push him back, man. But RoXKIS, they have everything they need to go uphill once again. This fight, they're just gonna keep coming at VirtusPro over and over again because now they've got everything that they need to fight. And MKB is now up on this Mirana. Solo is huge on this this bottom.
The AC is also done for BZZ.
Yeah.
So they have Monkey King Bar. You got AC up and running. The Refresher Orb is there for OD. He just bought a refresher. Now, this is burning for two different reasons. It's not just the OD ulti, but it's also the Scythe of Vice, which is going to be coming twice. Mm-hmm. So you're able to hold someone in position for a very, very long time. And then you got Visage, Mr. Aghanim Scepter. He doesn't really have much more to go with that, but at least got a ghost setter to stay alive. And then you got Lifestealer with AC, Armlet, Vashar. Are they found it? Oh, wow. That's the pickoff with the DD action rune. They could be looking to kill.
Yeah, they're looking to end the game right here, right now. They've got everything in the world going their way. VP's lineup was meant to end this game by 25, 30 minutes in. And now we're almost reaching the 40-minute mark. This is looking really, really bad for VirtusPro. And even if they are able to, again, contest the team fight from RoXKIS.
They're coming out for a bristleback. I don't know if VP saw him leap or not, but Illidan's going to walk in front ways. The arrow comes up towards the high ground, and they're coming in through the mid while the Bristleback is not ready to defend. And they just say, just focus on the melee racks. Get this sucker down first, which means even if this fight goes badly, Ross, yes, one more attack, thank you. He finally will have the advantage here, taking out the range racks as well, and they can back out. Bounty's coming up in a moment, but their objective is already achieved. They've crippled VP in the mid lane.
Yeah, and then they immediately go ahead and just take a tier two as well. Like, that's even more gold funneling the way of RoXKIS. I mean, they have all the items they need, but now you can talk about, like, the big luxury items, like another stun up. Abyssal could be picked up by BZZ. Oh, good. It's not just you. I was, like, lagging earlier.
Volvo, please fix! Volvo, please fix! And it's not our internet this time around.
Sweet.
It's actually the server problems again. But right now, RoXKIS definitely have this game. Like, that's not correct. neither is that. Because that graph bugs out as we come out of this. But, yeah. Right now, RoXKIS have basically got this game completely in the bag. It would take a team fight beyond all team fights for them to get the upper hand here.
Yeah, honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if this game does go south with us having to reconnect.
Well, I have a bit more of a problem because there's still four more. Ooh, we're in. So everyone's reconnected. It seems to Greenpeace is sad. So all the trees disappear when we do a reconnect like this. But it seems we're back in again, and everyone's alive.
And everyone's back to the base.
Look, actually, it didn't pause instantly because the creep wave has now reached the tier 3 tower.
Yeah, and exactly, and all of RoXKIS are back at their base. So they've lost their positioning. I mean, they took a tier 2, and that's what's important. They were probably going to wait till Roshan was back up anyway, which should be up in 3 to 4 minutes time.
The timer is broken.
Yeah, the timer is broken.
The timer won't come back up again when you've done a reload like this.
But they lost the Aegis at that mid-fight. So I'm going to guess 4 to 5 minutes. So they could probably just play passive and wait for that. And especially with the Dire side in the middle constantly being pushed in, it's very, very likely that they'll have such good map control at that time when Roshan is up that VirtusPro, like, they could think about smoking up and trying to get there, but it's going to be super, super obvious when RoXKIS try and take it and VirtusPro try and contest. RoXKIS are going to have every single heads up in the world.
This one little mega melee creep is being controlled by Enchantress. It's like, please look and see what they are doing. And he finds BZZ. And they'll see a Mirana on this bottom lane. Also, Mirana with a Hyperstone. This is a quick attacking Mirana right now. And when, well, it just needs the quick attack. That's it. Like, it's not meant to go into anything else. All he's looking for is the attack speed. Like, would you really want to put him on? Oh, look at that. They're guessing too. They think Smile is stalking him. Y'all pop the dust off just in case. And now they're coming towards mid lane. Fiend's grip on Illidan. And BZZ walks up. They let Illidan stand there. Refresher orb ulti. Refresher orb ulti. It's a double hammer. One of the left and right hooks. And God's going to go down. And that is GG right there. Yeah. RoXKIS have obliterated VirtusPro. After we've had ourselves a reload. After we've had ourselves a reconnect. RoXKIS finally get their combination off and they will take the victory here up against VirtusPro and push their advantage here in the competition where VP, they're able to at least claim one victory this evening and they'll go 1-3 now in the competition and RoXKIS, they'll go 2-3 after their 5 games.
Yeah, it looks like despite the fact that Ice Frog seemed to have had rares on VirtusPro, it didn't seem to matter. RoXKIS proved to be just way too strong. And it all came down to that beautiful Roshan play. That was exactly, it was such a huge upset. The moment that happened, they wiped everything. Yeah. I talked about, like, look at the gold grab. That is going to be such a big key factor because they all of a sudden have their basic amount of items to contest VirtusPro. In regular 5v5 engagements. And they no longer need that big surprise factor of Roshan or something like that. So RoXKIS, just with that beautiful play, turned the whole entire game around.
Man, and it's going to go down. Like, that right there is one of those things, like, Noob from UA is going to be all over. Like, oh, highlight yeah. clips, highlight clips, highlight clips. Because it was...
He should throw that in at the last part. It's just you.
Highlight clips, highlight clips. We need more. We need more. I kind of almost want to watch the fight again if we can wait, like, a minute.
You do that, and I'll get into the next game.
Yeah, jump into the next game. Yeah, because the guys are already ready to go. So make sure you stay tuned, because Cloud9 is going up against Team Liquid next. As always, you can follow the tournament over at mlg.joindota.com. That is the place to find out the standings of the tournament. You can check out the good recaps too, which our awesome news writers are taking care of. So yeah, check it out, peoples. Check it out. And just for your viewing pleasure, here is the moment again. Here is the moment again. Mirana ulti in. The Fiend's Grip to keep one of them out. And then the OD. Boom one, boom two. Triple kill on it. And then Razor stands there. The complete focus target of the entire team, Mirana. And then the Bristleback goes, well, I couldn't do anything. It's not my fault. It's not my fault. GG it out. The game was good. The game was golden. And the game is over.
Yeah, and we've got an even better game coming up. Cloud9 versus Liquid is pretty highly anticipated match. And also gives me a little bit of heads up in what I'll see tomorrow for the Dota 2 Champions League.
It should be awesome, dude. Yeah. It should be awesome. So stay tuned, everyone. We'll be back here in a couple of moments. Time for Team Liquid going up against Cloud9.